Good morning. One of the assignments we have for the class is looking up aftermarket parts and verifying they are legal to be installed on a California vehicle undergoing a state smog inspection. So in order to do that, you have a list on your homework of items to look up, and we're going to direct you to the California Air Resources Board website, and that is arb.ca.gov, and I have that up right here on the website. So this is the home page for the website. As we scroll down to the bottom of the page, we're going to see a thing that says aftermarket part in one of the portholes. You're going to click on aftermarket parts. That'll bring up a couple choices. One is performance and add-on parts. So that's where I would look up my cold air intakes or a turbocharger or supercharger. The next one is catalytic converters. So catalytic converters, where I'm going to go for all my catalytic converter questions, whether those catalytic converters were installed before January 1 of 09 or after January 1 of 09. The performance and add-on parts, I can look things up by either, as we'll see here, I can either look them up by the executive order number by simply typing in the executive order number. And I'm going to use one here from K&N 26915. And if I click search EOs, it'll come up with a page showing me that. So if I take a look here, and that is still what we're sharing. I just want to make sure I didn't lose anybody. Okay, so from here, I can see on this EO, I can see all the vehicles that that covers. If I want to view the actual document, I can click View PDF. Coming back to here, I can also search by manufacturer. By searching by manufacturer, I can go and say, you know what, I want to look up something in particular, such as air filter, cold air intake modifications, and search EOs. And when I search the EOs, I can see that I have all the EOs by manufacturer name, in this case, AEM, Advanced Engine Management, and that's going to go all the way through Z. So you can see this takes a lot longer. So this is not something I'm going to want to necessarily look for. And this could take a lot longer to get through. It does have a lot of information, but it's a very tedious way of doing it. On the other hand, if I had a car, for example, my pickup truck, and I was looking to see, does anyone make a fuel injection kit legal for it? I could use this database, search fuel injection kits, and look through every one to see if anybody has an approved kit for my particular vehicle. So I'm going to back up a little bit here. And we're going to go to catalytic converters. You also see there's a tab there for motorcycles. We're not going to worry about that because we don't smog motorcycles at this time. So catalytic converters. The catalytic converter page is divided into a couple places. I have the catalytic converter database, which is what I'll use for OBD2 vehicles, for looking up catalytic converters manufactured after January 1 of 09 to make sure those converters are CARB approved. I also, if that database is not working correctly, I would want to click on compatibility view, and it'll tell me how to put my browser into compatibility view, because sometimes the browsers don't work properly if that's not turned on. We also have a list of rescinded executive orders if I just wanted to look at that list. Although when I look up a regular executive order, it'll tell me if it's been rescinded. So we really don't need to do that. There's also a special link here for Toyota 4.7 liter Sequoias and Tundras that had some cataloging and manufacturing errors. And this kind of breaks that down and lets you know what's legal. To access all the executive orders shown in the database, I can see a complete list of approved catalytic converters under the new regulations. So that is just going to be a numerical list, and I'll pull that up real quick. And it lists all the converters from all the manufacturers listed under the new regulations. So you can see we have several pages of them. Again, since the executive order numbers are highlighted in blue, I can click on those and read those. On the right side, you can see where it says PC1 or T1 or T2. And when we talked about in the PowerPoint, the different ways we classify vehicles for purpose of emissions that we'd use on non-OBD2 vehicles to make sure that that's a legal converter. So I'm gonna back out of this. I'm gonna come down here to where I can see only pre-OBD2 vehicles under the new regulation. So here's my pre-OBD2 listing. This is the listing we use. And you can see how prominently they display T2 or PC2 or PC1 or T1. So on pre-OBD2 vehicles, I don't need to match up the engine family. I just have to match up the engine, the vehicle classification, make sure the engine size is applicable to the EO, and then I can use any of the part numbers with the category certification. So when we're verifying vehicles on a catalytic converter for purpose of smog inspection, this is where we go on a pre-OBD2 vehicle using the newer catalytic converters manufactured since January 1 of 09 that have the EO number directly on the catalytic converter shell. We will not use this for older converters that do not have the EO number on the shell of the converter. I'm going to back out of here and go back to our menu. For information on executive orders listed under the old regulations, view the summary list. This is the only place, and this is kind of hidden. You see the color of it's a little bit different, and this is hidden, and I would highly recommend downloading this and saving this 7-page PDF. This is the only way we have of taking these older series numbers on catalytic converters and the manufacturer code and putting those together and getting an EO number that's actually searchable and that can be looked up. So for example, here I can see the different companies. There are several pages. TA is Walker Manufacturing, which I used in the PowerPoint. Here is their series number. Here is the maximum engine size and test weight that that converter is rated to. If I want to know if this is an OBD2 certified converter, I'd either need to look at the date it was certified. Obviously, 1994, it's not going to be. But if it's a later certification date, such as 03, I would need to click on the executive order number to see if those converters are certified for an OBD2 vehicle or not. Just because the converters are certified after 96, do not assume they're OBD2 compliant, because OBD2 converters were not certified until the early 2000s. People had to put the factory converter back on. And there's still possibly some of those cars out there that people before you have not properly inspected. So I'm gonna back out of this and go back to, just back out of this page. And I'm gonna come up to our catalytic converter database. And this is our main search function we use for all catalytic converters after 2009. And if I want to install a catalytic converter on a new vehicle, that's going to tell me if anyone makes one for that vehicle and what manufacturers are available, what their part number is. So as I click on the database here, it's going to bring my database up, and I can search just by the EO number. And I have a drop down menu that I can go through that, or I can go through vehicle search. And I'm going to use vehicle search. So I'm going to look up a catalytic converter for a Honda. And I'm going to go with a 2010. Let's go with an Accord with a 2.3 or 2.4 in this case, a little newer vehicle. So 2.4. And I'm going to click search. And this is going to show me all the catalytic converters that are available for this vehicle. In this case, Car Sound and Walker are the only two manufacturers that make a legal catalytic converter for this. So if I had a catalytic converter that was from another manufacturer, it would not be legal. This shows me the executive order number that's allowed to be on. There's only two of them that are approved, the 193-137 from Car Sound and the 182-72 from Walker. It also tells me where they're supposed to be installed. In this case, we have the front of the vehicle or under the body. This car has two catalytic converters, as is clearly displayed here. So this part number can only be installed at the front of the vehicle, basically where the warm-up converter is. And this part number can only be installed under the vehicle. And if you notice, the one under the vehicle is a universal converter. That means it's going to be a weld-in. The direct fit is going to be a bolt-in converter. It's going to be installed exactly how the factory one was installed. Also over here on my test group, that's our engine family. That's what I have to match up on my underhood label for this converter to be legal. So I can look here that I have, again, the last three digits indicate the emission certification level. Here only the MB3 certification level has aftermarket converters. So if this is a PZEV vehicle with a different certification level, it will not be legal on this vehicle. So I hope this helps. as you're going through and doing the aftermarket parts exercise that's in your Canvas curriculum. And good luck. If you have any questions or are unable to locate something, please refer back to this video. Thank you very much for your time and have some fun.